Alrighty, guys and gals. Well, mostly guys, based on my analytics there on YouTube. Welcome back, guys, to the former Redbeard Ops workshop, or soon to be former Redbeard Ops workshop. Y'all can already see in the background here that I've moved most of the equipment already by the time I'm filming this video. But as y'all can tell by the thumbnail and the title, I am moving workshops. So I'm gonna be showing y'all how I moved a bunch of this heavy equipment. I bought some tools to help me do that on my own. I figured I could hire movers, or I can buy the equipment to allow me to move a bunch of heavy stuff on my own and then keep that equipment for future moves, or even just moving stuff around the shop easily on my own in the future. So that's what this video is gonna be about. Just know that there are gonna be a bunch of videos coming up of moving to the new shop, getting everything set up. Also, we're probably gonna be building a new shop at the new location. I'm gonna go to a temporary location first, kind of as an intermediate step, and then we'll build a new shop just for the Redbeard Ops workshop, making knives and stuff like that. So it's gonna be a beautiful new shop, hopefully, if everything works out the way that we want it to. And I would love to hear y'all's comments in the comment section below about what you wanna see, and also what you would want in a new workshop. So with all of that, let's get on with this video, and I'll go to my normal video narration. So during the intro, what y'all saw me doing was putting my Harbor Freight mini mill into the crate my little machine shop mill arrived in. I figured this would be a good way to transport it. I'm going to be palletizing the majority of my shop so that come loading day, I can use this awesome Apollo manual forklift that I purchased off Amazon. Let me know in the comments if y'all are interested in a full detailed review of this manual stacker, but in the meantime, I can say that it exceeded my expectations, and it's going to be nice having this guy around the shop in the future. The max load capacity for this lift is 1100 pounds, and I tested that multiple times during this move. With a little thought and ingenuity, this stacker can make moving heavy items around the shop way easier and safer. I'll put a link in the description below if you're interested in getting one. Not only did I palletize boxes and totes, but I also put some of my machinery on pallets like my Atlas lathe, 2x72 belt grinder, and anvil. I was able to get these pallets for free in town by asking around at places like Harbor Freight and CVS. After playing around with this stacker, I think it would be fun to build a lower capacity crane attachment that can act as a cherry picker capable of a few hundred pounds in the future. This would aid in lifts where the stacker's feet could not be under the item. This brings me to a quick note on this specific stacker. The support legs are under the forks, which requires normal pallets to be modified. I chose this configuration to aid in maneuverability with the smaller spaces I generally work in. Once I have everything on pallets, I decided to load one pallet into my pickup truck to save space in the large truck that I'll be renting. I wasn't sure about what the weather would be like on my drive, so I coated the lathe in oil and wrapped it in a tarp. Loading the pallet onto the truck was pretty painless, and all I had to do was take small bites on the pallet to slide it deeper into the truck. For this move, I'll be renting a 26-foot Penske truck with a 3,000-pound lift gate. Having this gate was instrumental on the success of my move.
Well, I just picked up the 26-footer from Penske with the lift gate. This thing is huge. I haven't driven anything this big, probably ever, or at least in a very long time. So I am officially the most dangerous guy on the road. So let's get out of this thing and start loading it.
The first thing I decided to put in the truck was my recently built DIY hydraulic press, which weighs around 650 pounds. I raised the lift gate so that it was parallel with the driveway, and then used the stacker to place the press onto the lift gate. After that, I locked the wheels, raised the lift gate, and rolled the press into the truck. I'm not a pro mover, however, I'm fairly sure it's ideal to have your heaviest items towards the cab. For me, this was the press and my 1100-pound gun safe. I'll likely be posting another video after this one on how I move my gun safe specifically, since it required custom fabrication and some Egyptian-like techniques. Once I had the press and safe into the truck, I started loading the rest of the pallets. I tried a few different methods for loading these pallets before I landed on one that worked best for me. The first attempt was to use this pallet dolly I made out of an old pallet and some casters. The idea was to get the pallet onto the pallet dolly, roll it into the truck, and then lift the stacker into the truck to maneuver it. It was good in concept, but failed on the first try when the wheel broke off. While I was pondering the pallet situation, we got the steel workbench loaded into the truck. This was a little touch and go, but we took our time to get it in and nothing fell or broke.
The next pallet was small enough to fit side by side with the stacker, so I was able to bring them both up to the bed at the same time, then maneuver the pallet to its assigned location. The pallet after this one demonstrates my final loading technique, which made the rest of the loading much easier. Firstly, the lift gate was folded up so that it's out of the way. I would then jack up the pallet to the level of the bed and place the pallet into the truck. Lastly, I'd unfold the lift gate and use it to bring the stacker into the truck so that I could maneuver the pallet. I was able to use this technique for the rest of the pallets, and I also used it when unloading the equipment. All in all, this loading process took around 4.5 hours. I then drove to a temporary staging location and unloaded this cargo in about 3 hours. I didn't feel like this footage was worth showing, since it was the same process, just in reverse. While I really liked this shop and was looking forward to building it out, life can throw you a curveball from time to time, and it's our job as responsible humans to adapt to these changing conditions. I'm really excited for the next part of this channel's journey, and I hope that y'all will also enjoy watching. Building a shop from the ground up is an intimidating venture, however, this will give us the opportunity to make it our own. So please drop some suggestions down in the comments for what you would want in a custom shop. So yeah guys, buckle up for a wild ride. I'll catch y'all on the flip side.